Well, there will be another chance tonight for some people in Northern California to get a rare glimpse of the Northern Lights. KCRA3's Dirk Verdoren is joining us now with some solar storm activity and how it could give us a spectacular show. Hey, Dirk.
It could give some a spectacular show. Again, I just want to emphasize that there's no guarantee that it's going to be in our area, but the farther north you go, the better chance you have of running into the aurora. But what's going on? What causes this? Well, let's go ahead and take a look at the solar activity. This was actually an image taken from a satellite about 2 days ago, so it was May 9th, and this was a coronal mass ejection. You can see that explosion as it takes place as it just makes its way out of it's basically in the solar atmosphere as it ejects out, and that's plasma, and it's made up of electrons and protons that are moving at, this explosion is over 2 million miles an hour. Now, it takes about 2 days to make its way from the sun to the Earth, and that's what gives us the chance for some aurora. Right now, the aurora circle is right in through the Arctic Circle. You can see that area of green, and that's where the aurora is happening at this point, and through Canada, Alaska, all the places where we typically see it. But as we go through tonight and into tomorrow, we could see that work its way a little bit farther south. So a coronal mass ejection as strong as this leads to the potential where we could see Northern Lights as far south as Oregon, Nebraska, and Virginia. So head north and you might be able to see it. That's what's going on. Now back over to you.